it is needed. So again, the nasal cavity and nasopharynx, it is a two nerves. There is only spinocerebellar ganglia and the other one is anterior ethmoidal nerve. The medial and lateral part of the part of nasal cavity is supplied by anterior ethmoidal branch of nasal ear nerve and the posterior by the spinopalatine ganglion. So this is the cut section which shows where the nerve ending comes. So you can see the nerve ending, the very important nerve ending is from the spinopalatine ganglion. Usually we have to apply 4% lignocaine with 1 in 2 lakh adrenaline over the mucosa in such a way that you would have all done already. But the very important thing is you have to apply it in the posterior aspect so that you have a contact in the posterior pharyngeal wall, especially in the place where spinopalatine ganglion lies. So our pack should be in such a way that we have to direct it backwards posteriorly and it should touch the posterior pharyngeal wall, especially the spinopalatine ganglion, and the contact should be at least 5 to 10 minutes. So this is one of the video which is I am going to show the endoscopic anatomy where the spinopalatine ganglion lies. This is a first patient under general anesthesia we are doing. And you can see the nasal endoscopy. So you can see the middle and lower turbinate in this place. You can see the middle turbinate. This is the space between the middle turbinate and the inferior turbinate. And you can see the structure which is nothing but the spinopalatine ganglion. So it is very important if you pack, you have to pack in such a way the cotton soaked in lidocaine should go posteriorly and should touch the spinopalatine ganglion. Next, this is one of the atomizer devices. What is atomization? It's nothing but conversion of bulk liquid into spray or mist-like structures. So the local anesthetic will be sprayed into multiple tiny spots so that the absorption or topicalization will be easy and it's better with lesser amount of local anesthetics. This is one such equipment which is available, and this is one more recently available technique, that is McKinsey technique, where we can use on our own. The commercially routinely available things like it consists of a arterial cannula, a three-way adapter, a syringe with local anesthetics, monomal syringe and oxygen tubing. So the advantage of this is we can utilize the flow of oxygen for local anesthesia. This is one video which again I am going to show that how to give this. We devise that we utilize the available things and we devise the atomization device. And you can see during first you can see the spray of local anesthetics. This is just we are using only 2 ml of local anesthetics along with oxygen, how it is being sprayed, and it covers the entire nasal mucosa so that there won't be any spot of unanesthetized portion. So next comes the very important thing which is commonly used, that is nebulization. This is very easy to perform and it is very simple and it produces very less discomfort to the patient. You can make the patient sit upright and you can